Hello everyone, this is Arthur the Bootlet Usurper. Welcome back to Dark Souls 3 the Bootlet Night Walkthrough. Last time we've explored further into Arch Dragon Peak. Well, continued our exploration to Arch Dragon Peak. For this episode, we're going to take on the Nameless King, the last boss of this area, and one of the few remaining children of Gwyn's that are still alive. Now let's pull this lever. There's our battleground. I like the sound it makes. Now, for phase one, we're gonna fight with the sword. Phase two, we're gonna go with spells, cause fucking phase two is a real asshole. Ow! Okay, so you can hit for our shield. Come on, spray your fire. There we go. Repost. Ow, shit. Okay, there's phase one. Now, this cutscene will make you think of Orange Seed and Smoke. You'll see why in a moment. Damn, he buff. God, he's as hollow as his father. Yep! That's where the Orange Seed Smoke reference comes in. Where one absorbs the other. At least that's what it makes me think of. My fault. Honestly, I figured we could take him. Nope. Now, maybe part of the problem was me deciding to go just melee for first phase, because Damn Dryad takes a while to hit. Wow, the textures are not loading at all. Ah. At least we got our souls back. This is for the boosted hit points. Yeah, screw it. We're gonna do magic for both. And melee when we can. Because apparently the flame lasts for a while. That's a thing. Well, at least this walkthrough is mostly don't necessarily do everything I do. Why are all these textures not loaded? It's so weird. So this is the most amount of times I've actually died in a boss fight. I mean, it's expected, but I always want to get to phase two before he fucking owns me. So, Mixo, dodge! What? I think maybe melee would work better. Ow! Fuck! Repost! Marcus, I nearly dodged that one. Yes! Third time's the charm. No, I was wrong about purely magic on him. Although there have been times where I've been able to cheese him just in one fight. But that's basically how we killed an Able's King. In my case, it was just mixing melee and magic. I think it was more melee. Overall, we used like about half our regular Estus for the fight and one Ashen Blast. This is where you fight the Nameless King. Oh wait, we were here before. Light the bonfire. But let's rest. Now, we're gonna explore this just to get some items. Titanite Slab, that's number 5. I believe that's the 5th Titanite Slab we've found in the game. Got one from Sigward. Got one from the Winged Angels, those Gold Wing Angels. Got one from the Shortcut to Grand Archives boss room. And we got one from... Shit, I know we got one from somewhere else. This is gonna take a while. Partially because everything's so bright. I mean, it's kind of unusual compared to, well, the majority of the game where it's dusk and shit. Actually, I'm gonna Google Titanite Slab locations. Because I know we got one from somewhere. Ah, first link. Oh, turns out if we put all the cinders of a lord on their respective thrones, we can get one from the Shrine Handmaid for 30,000 souls. That's another one. Oh, there's apparently 3 at the Grand Archives. See, we got 2 from Grand Archives, 1 from Sigward. Okay, we got another one next to the Hollow Knight. So that's 5. Apparently there's 1 that's near the Crystal Sages. Well, near the Crystal Sage of the Grand Archives. Okay, I am so lost. Feels like there's... Okay, there's gotta be something here. Oh shit, I think that may be... A lot of this is gonna be when we run around because it's so damn bright here. Okay, I could swear Ord Steve's armor was here. Was that it? Was it tie-dye slap it? Because, wow, that's kind of disappointing. Yay, parkour jumping! Okay, I could swear Orange Steve's armor is here. Yeah, I agree with that person who posted that. Pointless. Oh, turns out there's like 7 total you'll find in the DLCs. 3 in Aria Dell, the Painted World DLC, and 4 at Ring City. Get 8 in the base game. Ah! Well, I can be detained by trade Cold Sword Fragment from Crow. We haven't found 2. 3? Okay, so there's 3 left that we need to find. 1 at Grand Archives and 2 are Firelink. Okay, so it's apparently somewhere further to the left. Oh my god, wow, I just somehow, again, bright area. Now, some people have theorized about Ornstein, where he is. It's very how he apparently left Smoke alone to guard Honor Londo. There was some theorized that Ornstein really... Well, he basically left in search of the Nameless King, but they theorized that the Nameless King either killed him or turned him into that dragon thing we fought. Don't know which, but let's get the hell out of here. Oh, also, fun tip. One of the recent patches to the game added that plume on Ornstein's helmet. It wasn't there before.
Ah.
Okay, so let's see. For being Nameless King, we get... Well, Nameless Cake set. Or Golden set and Dragon Scale set. Yep, basically, so the first sword, here's the Lorien set. And from Ormec, we get his nice looking coat. And I think this is from the... Oh yeah, Jawa's Ashes.
Ashen one.
Alright. Now that I've basically diddled around enough in Archer Dragon Peak trying to look for Ordsy's armor, let's just give Vladloff the Nameless King Soul. You can make three things out of it. Lightning Storm Miracle. Storm Curve Sword of... Well, rare all those wind attacks he does, this base allows you to do. And then here's his Dragonslayer Sword Spear. And that is titular weapon, a Dragonslayer Sword Spear. Now let's just make... Yeah, make this. And I could possibly, if I ever want to, someday make a fate build, just farm for every stupid miracle. The harsh part of that is, again, the Dark Moon Blades. Because apparently they wanted to make that as hard as possible. Oh well.
Welcome, speak. Very well, then take Nar.
We're gonna level up, and first thing we're gonna do is pop up into attunement.
Farewell, me.
There we go, now I can fire four Crystal Soul Spears in a row. Without buffing my staff, which I've never done. As we're basically done for this episode, next one, the final fight is upon us. It's like the next episode, we're gonna put Rothric's cinders on his throne. Then go from there to the final boss fight. And finally, usurp the flame. So, end game, for the most part, it's gonna be final episode 35. Now I'm probably gonna start up a new playlist of the DLCs. Not put them in the same one as this. And they'll be titled differently. Don't know what I'll title them, but it'll be different. But I'll probably take a big break just to get into PvP a little bit. And I'll probably come back. How long will that break me? I don't know. Depends on whether or not I get into some of the games I've been meaning to play for a while. Or get back into playing. But anyways, okay, that was redundant. Anyways, this is it for this episode. Next time, we shall usurp the flame. Bye, everyone.